time when journalists had some respect and value. And obviously, becoming a journalist was the dream job for any individual. But these days, is that your dream job? Or you are confused. You want to become a journalist, but you don't want to become a journalist. Why? But obvious, looking at this primetime debates, the way these jokers are shouting and giving all the news which is not even important, I don't think so anyone of you, the educated ones, want to become a journalist anymore or the primetime anchors. Yes, guys, most of you are here searching for want to be a YouTube journalist. But definitely the question comes in that is it possible? Will I be considered as a serious journalist? Is there a future? Will I earn something? So guys, yes, in this video, I'm going to tell you the reality about a YouTube journalist. How can you become a YouTube journalist? Whether you can make your future as a YouTube journalist. Hey guys, this is Pooja Gupta. Welcome to Media Mentor. Some of them call them as vlogger, content creators, YouTubers. But no one can deny the fact that YouTubers or the content creators, influencers, vloggers are much more in demand than a journalist. We have seen a drastic change on the internet, and especially when you talk about social media platform and the YouTube, there has been a major change. And let me tell you what happened in 2015 when the President Obama visited India. He preferred giving interview to the YouTubers rather than the primetime anchors. Can you believe it? It's a dream for any journalist to get a one-on-one interview from the president. But he went on giving the interview to the random YouTubers. Can you see this switch? It was a big slap on the primetime anchors and established journalists. So now when you talk about the YouTubers who have just started their career 2 to 3 years back is able to do the biggest interview of their life. And on the other hand, where the journalists are schooling for years and years, working as a reporter for a few years and becoming a primetime anchors, they are not able to get their job. It is obvious that the platform is evolving. People's preference is changing. Especially when they want to target the youth audience, the teenagers, they know that obviously they can relate to the YouTubers, influencers and content creators better than the serious anchors. Obviously, Obama's interview was a strategic step by their PR. Obviously, it was a successful step. Why? Because there was a huge engagement when he did an online interview, an YouTube interview. And hence, we can actually say it's blurring the line between the new form of journalism, which you say a citizen journalism or YouTube journalism, and the traditional journalism. An independent person who have millions of followers will definitely get a better chance than a person working with a big organization as just a journalist tag. That was 2015. Now talking about recently, in past 3-4 years, what you have seen, majority of the movie stars are going to this YouTubers, going on their platform and promoting the movies, right? Whether you talk about any upcoming movie, all the celebrities you'll find with these YouTubers doing an interview, doing some collaboration. That is how they are deciding to promote their movies. For example, even Shashi Tharoor preferred to come and talk with Kunal Kamra. Now, these all things are serious stuff coming on the YouTube platform, which was just considered to be the entertainment. But now it can be called as new form of infotainment, which is information with the entertainment, and people are preferring it a lot more. Okay, coming to the question, will all this kill the traditional journalism? If you ask my opinion, I don't think so it will kill the traditional form of journalism, because it's but obvious. See, when the radio came into existence, it was, you know, said that print will die. When television came into existence, everyone thought that radio and print will die. When internet came into existence, everyone said all three of them die. But everything coexisted. So similarly, I feel that when you talk about YouTube and social media, it will not kill anything. Everything will coexist because each one of the platforms or the media got its own audience. There are still set of people in the society which will not take YouTubers seriously. They will go to the well-reputed journalist only. So what I'm trying to say is nothing will disappear. Everything will coexist. It will be just that people's preference will change. Somebody will like YouTubers giving out the news and somebody would still prefer the traditional journalist. Okay, as most of you watching this videos are the youngsters who want to make your career in media as a journalist or, you know, want to make your presence on the YouTube platform. Let me tell you guys, this is the future. Why? Because most of the youngsters, most of the teenagers and even the adults are consuming news on the social media platform. So what happens is you have to be really tech savvy. In terms, you have to get used to using the social media platform. So what I would suggest is, even the traditional journalist can do one thing, that they have to evolve. It is just an add-on because it has become easier for each one of us to present the news or pass on the information. So it's an add-on tool. And for the people who are just entering into the media field or the journalism field, guys, for you, it is very important that you understand the platform because it's massive. So, I would like to give some of the examples. First thing, if you talk about Dhruv Rathi, you would have seen his videos. Definitely, he is doing a brilliant job. He is not a journalist. He never calls himself a journalist. He says, I'm a content creator. I'm a YouTuber. He got more than 45 lakh subscribers. And on the other hand, when you talk about Faye D'Souza, she is an established journalist, right? But she got some 1.5 lakh subscribers on her YouTube channel. So it's just that people are consuming news or people are consuming the information where they are able to understand and relate. So why I'm giving this example, that yes, you can look at these factors and understand that what you want to do on the YouTube platform. So if you want to become a YouTube journalist, as I said, first thing, you have to understand the social media platform from where you will gather the news. And once you're giving out the news, who are your audience? What will be your language? What kind of news you want to cover? You have to define that area that yes, people will come to your channel to watch that particular kind of a news or information. Also, you need to understand one thing, that it's not easy. YouTube platform, there is a lot of content flowing in for each type of content. So you have to identify your uniqueness, that how you will stand out of this whole clutter. You will have to really work hard to collect the information, to refine it, to write the script, to present it. And definitely, it will come over the period of time with the experience and the amount of time you will spend learning it. Now, let's talk about the most important thing. Will you earn money doing this YouTube full time? And secondly, will it be a secured future as a YouTube journalist? Yes, you can definitely earn money, but for that, you will have to get into the number game. See, everything on the social media platform, people will judge you with the number of subscribers. I am giving such a wonderful content, but yes, people will judge me of having such, you know, less number of subscribers. So yes, the number game is really important on the social media platform. And that will come once you start providing the good content and people start relating to your content. So you have to give yourself time. It might not give you money on the initial stages, but yes, once you get the number, you will start earning with the AdSenses, which everyone knows. Second, you will have the collaboration form, which you can earn. Thirdly, if you talk about all the independent YouTubers or the independent journalists, how they earn is they do content creation for the different platforms, as in like whether it's Spotify, Amazon, you talk about Netflix, then Hindustan Times, Quint. So you as an individual creating a certain content for these big companies definitely will fetch you money. So you can definitely earn, but for that you have to produce quality content. And yes, finally, can you have a secured future? Yes, you can have a secured future. For that, you have to really work very hard. And nobody can say which kind of content will work or which particular style will work. So you will have to keep experimenting, you will have to come up with ideas, keep exploring, and yes, definitely you never know, you can make a big hit. So yes, it is a kind of a secured future, but it will take time, it will take a lot of efforts. In the end, I would like to talk about the traditional media. All of us are just fed up with the style of reporting what goes on the mainstream media. Being the mainstream media, they are not highlighting what is going on in our country. So it is really disappointing. We all know that they are trying to create propaganda rather than giving us the news. Hence, the whole mainstream media or the whole journalism fraternity is somewhere dying. Because media is not doing the job correctly. That's why people are relying on individual personalities which they feel more connected with. So any individual who is giving a news in a right way, they are becoming popular among the people, among the youngsters, because at least they are trying to highlight the issue, trying to explain the thing properly and giving out the facts, which was the job of the mainstream media and our primetime anchors, which have become a mouthpiece of the government. Now, hence, I would strongly say that yes, somewhere mainstream media is dying and people really want to become an independent individual voice wherein they are more accountable and even they are responsible. While they are giving news, you can go and help them responsible. When the editors of the news channels are giving out fake news without having any logic and any proof, that shows that how the journalism is dead long back. I hope guys this video was informative. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.